Plant and Food Research is one of the largest horticultural scientific research organisations in the world. We do work right through from breeding different cultivars to understanding how those crops are grown, to understanding pests and diseases, and then also into the food innovation portfolio, which is really about understanding physiological health benefits of those foods. So I lead the group in a group called Food and Nutrition, which is in the food innovation portfolio. And really our focus is all about digestive health and nutrition. So it's what happens to food when we eat it and everything, all the processes that go through, biochemical processes, physiological processes, and quite a strong focus on gut bacteria as well and what's happening there. So plant food has an ongoing relationship with Anagenix. We have an agreement to continue working, particularly in the area of digestive health, to understand Actazin and other products as well. It's an important relationship for us, for New Zealand, because we want to work with New Zealand companies who are using New Zealand products, you know, grown here in New Zealand. And I suppose really the whole point of this is that we're providing scientifically validated information to the consumer so that they can understand what they're eating and what the health benefits are. So kiwifruit is one of the crops that we've been doing a lot of research into over the years at Plant and Food Research. And in terms of digestive health, kiwifruit have a lot of things about them which are relevant. So kiwifruit have a lot of fibre or non-digestible carbohydrates. They have polyphenolics, and they also have a very unique enzyme, which is helps to digest protein, so it's important in digestion. Kiwifruit, which are grown in the southern hemisphere, have a higher, or particularly in New Zealand, have a higher level of UV light that they're exposed to, and the plant's response to that is to produce more secondary metabolites. So secondary metabolites are the chemicals in the plants which we now know have health benefits. So things like polyphenols, carotenoids, anthocyanins, all of these are actually stress responses from the plant, but the research is showing that these are the things which give us the health benefit. So the results from the clinical trial were very interesting in terms of the healthy cohort. There were statistically significant increases in stool frequency, which is the primary outcome measure. So this is the measure that the study was powered for, which meant that over the course of a week, there was an increase in at least one bowel motion per week. Now what we do in clinical trials, particularly with foods, because they are hampered by individual variability, if you like, everyone is very different, is now it's becoming more common practice to stratify results, just to look in more detail. And for that, we need to classify people into responders and non-responders. And when we did this stratification for the clinical trial, we found that in responders, we had a statistically significant increase in stool frequency for the low dose, so that's the 600 mg sample of Actazin, and the high dose, which is the 4 capsule dose. So what does this actually mean in terms of a benefit to the person taking them? What we believe is that if you have quite a bad constipation time, if you take the high dose, that will sort of get things moving for you. But then once you're sort of back more into a normal pattern, if you take the 600 mg dose, that will perhaps have a maintenance effect in terms of your laxation. We believe that it's important to keep taking the product, the Actazin product, because once you stop taking Actazin, the stool frequency is likely to tail off. We know that the gut responds quite quickly. So for other foods that we've looked at Plant and Food Research, for example, within about 1 or 2 weeks, you go back to your baseline levels of stool frequency per week. So really, if you want to keep healthy and you want to keep things regular, you need to be keeping at least with a maintenance dose of 600 mg of Actazin. Whenever we do a clinical trial, we want to actually look at what that means for the consumer. Richard, the gastroenterologist Richard Geary, and I have discussed the outcomes of this trial. and what we consider to be clinically relevant. So the FDA actually has very strict guidelines as around what they consider to be a significant improvement clinically for bowel motions, and they say that they've actually done it for an IBS population, but it's relevant for the whole population as well. So anything which is greater than one, an increase of one stool motion per week is considered to be clinically relevant. So that's what we found in this trial with the high dose Actazin.